It's September 1st. Welcome to Inside the Show as rosters have expanded. Looking first at the NL East, Yimi Garcia collected his eighth win in relief as the Marlins took down the Diamondbacks 3-2. The New York Mets hit three long balls as they bested the visiting Rockies 4-3. The Chicago Cubs combined for 10 hits as a team as they defeated the visiting Giants 7-4. The Reds combined to allow only 4 hits as they took down the visiting Orioles 2-1. The Brew Crew totaled 11 hits as they defeated the Pirates at PNC Park 8-5. The Philadelphia Phillies knocked out 10 hits as a team as they cruised to the win over the Cardinals 7-0. The Yankees sent 3 balls into the seats as they took down the Red Sox on the road 6-4. The Chicago White Sox knocked out 12 hits as a team as they took down the Rays in St. Petersburg 4-2.
Inside the show. Inside the show.
Here's the Panda now, Pablo Sandoval, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third.
Gotta hold him here, guys. Let's go, Padres.
Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery.
Hey, this isn't going to be an easy save. These guys are making it work for this one.
Weak grounder down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. A little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. And that will get down as he delivers a big one here. It's a base hit. And he's safe.
Dan, you'll take RBIs any way you can get them, but when they give your team the lead in the late innings, man.
Alex, play ball.
Your attention, please. Now, pitching for
5-3, the final score in this afternoon's game. The Giants. And good evening to those of you just joining us on the show. You've chosen to tune in at a great time. Greg Garcia may be looking to go deep here as he and his team trail by one here in the ninth. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul.
This has to be a productive at-bat right here. I know you want to drive the run in and get the RBI. But you have to find a way, bare minimum, to move this run over the third.
On the ground, back up the box, and it'll get through into center field, a base hit. He's safe at the plate, and we are tied here in the bottom of the ninth.
You know, D-Row, in today's game, it's not easy scoring in the late innings. So that RBI base hit to tie things up, that comes at a really good time.
Yeah, I say it's not easy. They got 11 guys in a bullpen, and I don't think a guy throws under 97 miles an hour with sink and cut. That is unbelievable he's able to get that knock in that big spot.
Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. He's coming off a solo homer in his previous trip. Here's the first pitch. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series, and maybe even the whole week ahead.
Now the 2-0.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
The 3-0. 3-1 to him now. Possible winning run on first, one man away. And that misses ball four. So now the potential winning run moves into scoring position where a single could end this thing. Here's Manny Machado now. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
No balls in one strike. Ball and a strike now to Machado. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Possible game winners at second base here with one away. To two balls and two strikes now. To sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Ready with another two-strike offering. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. First baseman Eric Hosmer is in. He went down on strikes last time up. Here's the first pitch. His eyes lit up on that one above the zone, but he comes up empty.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That can be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
The 0-1 offering.
That's a great take right there. You knew the pitcher was going to try and expand the zone. 0-2 in a big spot, and he was able to spit on that one. Hopefully get something in the heart of the plate this pitch.
Here's a pop-up now, and that'll do it in the inning as the catch is made in the coach's.
Attention, please. Now pitching for the Padres, number 67.
Several good offensive performances in this one, but none better. And good evening to those of you just joining us on the show. You've chosen to tune in at a great time. The San Diego Padres batting here in the bottom of the inning, looking to send these fans home happy with a walk-off win. And here's a fastball called. for strike one. To short, hit hard. He's right there. The throw will go to third, but he gets back in time, safe at second base. Dominic Smith will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. And he fouls this one off. And facing right-handed pitching so far this season, Smith brings a batting line of barely over 200, so there's certainly some room for improvement there.
He'd be the first to tell you he's not happy with his batting average this season, but he can beat you in a variety of different ways, and he has to because he wouldn't be here otherwise.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Buxton is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. And he'll make it up safely to third, so they're at the corners now with two men out. And now is Yasiel Puig. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero. Well, he's hoping to be a hero and drive in the winning run, but that swing tells me he's a little too amped up. You don't chase a pitch that badly if you're playing within yourself.
Two balls and a strike now as that misses to the San Diego right fielder.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
Reined in on to first, and the Padre threat. Jared Eichhoff takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Into the score, Minnesota. Number 8, Nick Garber.
Two of the final score tonight, the Twins with a division best 102nd team win. Rich Hill records.
Happy Friday, baseball fans. Welcome to Inside the Show. Starting out in the NL.
Inside the Show. And now your host, Justin Allegri.
Great Sunday action lies ahead, but first, here's what happened in the major leagues on Saturday. Starting out in the NL West, Juan Nicasio won his first game of the season as San Diego beat the Dodgers 2-1. Entering the day's action, the Padres are in second place in the NL West, but they currently...
It's time for baseball on MLB Network. Today, the third and final game in this three-game series between the LA Dodgers and the San Diego Padres. Cody Bellinger, one of the league's best hitters, looks to gain ground in the chase for a National League batting title. First pitch is next. Joey Lucchesi gets the start for San Diego in this one. Dan, any thoughts?
You know, Matt, he wasn't all that bad in his last one. In a day and age where we don't see a lot of complete games, six full innings in his last one, and if they can score him a few runs, he has a chance to win this one here today.
Stepping into the box, Drew Jackson. So we check out how he did in August versus how he's finishing off the season down the stretch here in September. First offering on its way. Underway now in the Sunday finale as the game's first pitch is taken for ball one. Guys, these Padres, as they take the field this afternoon, 4-2 over their last six games, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty V, I think one of the toughest things, D-Row, is to keep playing with this sense of urgency. It looks like they're playoff bound, but the thing is, you need to keep going and not take your foot off the gas pedal.
Yeah, you need to be rewarded for the marathon, and that's exactly what this team has done. They've already clinched a playoff berth, and now they get ready for the sprint. Try and find a way to get healthy, but not lose focus.
1-1. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. We'll be in the 80s later this afternoon, but for now, 79 degrees at first pitch. Left side. And the day begins with an out. There's one away.
That is better. The better field number three. With Taylor.
So one away here with the bases empty. And in to hit next, it'll be the ever-versatile Chris Taylor. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
1-0.
Now the 1-0.
Two-pitch mix here. If you're in the batter's box, you're looking for something up. Sinker changeup right here. Got to get it up.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Oh. out toward right center. Myers is over to his right as he puts this one away. Two down.
Batting third.
Here's Mookie Betts. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Two pitch in the dirt, but swung on and missed. And the throw to first ends the inning. Nothing doing here in the opening half inning. Dodgers held scoreless early. Padres coming to bat. It's the battle for Southern California bragging rights, and it's on MLB Network. Julio Urías is on the mound for the Dodgers in this contest. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matt, it's not easy to bunch anything together against this guy. In his last three starts, he has a whip of under 1.10. So we may see some hit and run. We may see some bunting, and we may see some running, because if you want to lay around and try to get hits off this guy, that's not the right thing to do. One of the top pitchers in the game right now.
Down low, two balls and a strike.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. Scooter Gennett will be next. And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game. So here's Scooter Gennett in past meetings with Julio Urías. He's one for two. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
That was a pretty good fastball after he walked the hitter previous. There was a little angry on that heater.
Comes set and the 0-1.
Off the plate, ball one.
Gennett is a player referred to as clutch by teammates, coaches, and, of course, the media. He seems to find himself in pressure situations off. And that'll get on through into right field for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Boy, that's one of the, I guess, the advantages of hitting with that hole between first and second base, D-Row. First baseman has to hold that runner on. That leaves that right side wide open.
Yeah, and credit the batter right there. Nice piece of hitting right there. Not trying to do too much. He took a look at the defense and saw where it was aligned and tried to beat him.
1-0 the count. From the stretch. Ball and a strike. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Grisham over at second. Gennett on at first with nobody out. Takes this the other way to right. There to look it in his bets, and that's out number one. Time now to check the hometown Padres lineup card in this one. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, it's no secret. They need Manny Machado to get his bat going a little bit. He's only picked up one hit in this series, and I know this. I expect a lot more from him, and I think he expects more of himself, too. This could be the game that gets him going, though. A lot of times when these guys take overs, look out. They're just about to catch fire.
Ball one to start the at-bat. Wide, 2-0.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
3-0 now.
Not a good spot to be in right now. A pitch has fallen behind in the count with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
Padres shortstop ahead with a 3-ball, 1-strike count.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
And There's a called strike at the knees as he was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now, 3-2. And strike three called on the outside corner. He's earned the right to live out there with the fastballs as that's out number two. Two men on, two out, and standing in now the always dangerous third baseman, Manny Machado. And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half. A ball and a strike now to Machado. Arias has made a name for himself as a starter that simply misses the barrel of the bat. He rarely allows a large number of hits, and he does a pretty good job at keeping the ball in the ballpark when the hitters do make contact.
Yeah, Matt, that's not an easy thing to do. I think one of the reasons is he changes speeds really well, and he throws both sides of the plate. One of the keys to missing the barrels, you have to be able to throw inside and throw outside, and he's about as good as it gets in baseball at missing barrels.
That pitch misses for ball four. So some intrigue now as the bases are loaded here with two away. Digging in the switch hitter, Francisco Mejia. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night. That hits the outside corner. It's strike one.
So important getting ahead with the bases loaded. Already a difficult situation, so you don't want to make it any harder by falling behind in the count.
1-1 the count. The 1-1 pitch.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
In the air, out to right. Betts on the run, but he can't get to it, and this might clear the bases. One run is scored. As he arrives at second without a play, as they take the lead with two runs scoring on the play.
We didn't have to wait long for the offensive fireworks in this one. Two runners aboard, and he got a pitch he liked, drove it all the way to the wall to bring in a pair of runs, and they're still in good shape to add on with him at second now.
Standing in, Eric Hosmer, and he really thrives in the batter's box here at home. Something to keep an eye on in this one. Now a ground ball to Seager at short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this... Cody Bellinger at the plate now, and though he's been in a bit of a slump in the last few series, he's still in line to finish the season with one of the league's top batting averages.
Yeah, he's had a monumental season. You can't take that away from him, but I'm sure he'll tell you that he's fully aware he is right in line to potentially run down a batting crown, but not the way he's swinging the bat right now. He has to find a way to relax himself at the dish. So here's how the San Diego Padres are positioned defensively. And let's focus on Manny Machado, 2015 Gold Glove winner. Get the mantle space ready. He's going to add more to that. On the defensive side, he's a highlight reel at the hot corner.
A dive, but he can't get a glove on it. It's through for a base hit. He'll get it into second. The tag, and he's nabbed trying for two.
The first base.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. He's looking to get things going at the plate. It has not been going his way of late. Out in front of it, strike one. Pulled toward right center field. Back goes Grisham. But it's the right fielder that gets there to make the catch. So here's Will Myers. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he's really continued to turn in strong performances day after day. His average in his last 10 games is over the 300 mark, but then again, that's nothing new for him.
But easier said than done. This guy from start to finish has been on point, not giving any at-bats away. He's swinging a hot bat and making a strong push to end the season and put that batting title belt around his waist.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Digging in now, Joey Lucchesi. And you see that average below the dreaded Mendoza line. And he'll look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. comes too far inside, ball two.
Can't fall behind against the pitcher. Need to minimize pitch count against the easy outs, and this is certainly one of them.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. Strike two. Just the second inning, but already 37 pitches to this point. 2-2 pitch is a fastball high, so it runs full 3-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Another full count pitch on its way. And he lays off here. It's ball four. And that is really cause for concern as he's just walked the opposing pitcher.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
Ready for another chance? Trent Grisham. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. Well, as we've discussed, he's easily been one of the league's best bats, but his production has been merely good, not great, over his last 10 games, with his line over that stretch a little under 300.
He's finding a way to still mix in a knock over the last 10 games and keep himself above water in this batting title race, but he certainly doesn't look as comfortable as he did the previous couple months.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Well, we've, of course, spotlighted the positives of his season batting totals, but putting a microscope on the last 10 games, his batting numbers have actually dropped off to around the league average over that time.
He knows it. He knows he has to pick up the pace a little bit. This isn't going to get it done. The last 10 games, although he's finding ways to help his team and get on base.
Oh, and meanwhile, this pitch rides too far in and winds up hitting him.
Well, this home crowd didn't like this guy in the mound before, but now they really don't like him. He's gotten the faithful all worked up by hitting one of their best hitters early on in this game. And you can bet he's really going to hear it if he comes around to score.
Here comes the first pitch. And that one right down Main Street.
Especially after drilling the last guy up at the plate. That's just a great job to get your mechanics back under you and establish yourself back in the strike zone.
And he takes this one high, 1-1. From the belt, kicks and deals, fouled away. The 1-2. Pops this one up. Seager into shallow left. He can't get to it. This one's down. Throw into third. And that's the second out. Riding in once again, Tommy Pham hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat. From the belt, the pitch. Now time granted here at the plate as he'll step out of the box. The 1-0. As we mentioned earlier today, he's one of the league's best hitters overall, but he struggled recently, however, to the tune of a low 200s batting average in his last 10 games.
And this is the last time you want to go into a little.
And now a diving effort, but this is off the center fielder's glove. To third now, but he's safe. As also on the play, a run comes across to score.
Hey, guys, I like the execution by the batter there. He got a hanger in the middle of the plate. He could have come unglued, but he didn't. He stayed focused and drove a line drive base hit.
And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. as he'll take a look at ball one.
Even though we're still in the early going, I think this game's at a tipping point right now. They've got a chance to put this game out of reach, but if they can't score anymore here, the other guys feel like the door's still open.
2-0 now. The 2-0.
I tip my hat to the batter right there for taking that pitch. Most guys would have definitely been swinging in that situation. 2-0 fastball,
but that was not in the zone he was looking for. Move on to the next pitch.
Second and third, two away. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off speeds.
And he takes a big swing at that one as this one's lifted high in the air and deep out to left field. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning.
Two home runs in 3 days? I'd say he's seeing the ball pretty well right now. I think it's time to start pitching around this guy.
Now here's the Dodgers skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. Is going to come on in relief now, and he may be asked to eat several innings as this game is just still really getting underway. Here's Manny Machado now. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Definitely had the distance, but it winds up a foul ball. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Now another one hit deep to left. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall.
Sometimes when a reliever comes in a game, he wants to get that first strike so bad that he serves one up, and that's exactly what happens here. The first batter he faces just rockets one off the wall, and now he's got to worry about another base hit, potentially bringing home a run.
A couple of RBI. Digging in and looking for more, Manny Machado, one for two with a double on the ledger so far. He comes set, here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And he misses inside with that one, ball one. And he won't bite at that one either, it's 2-0.
Nowhere to put anybody, 2-0 count, not a good spot to be in as a pitcher.
Outside, 3-0 now.
Well, nothing can make you question yourself on that mound more than three straight balls to a guy you know that you should go right after. Sometimes you just lose the strike zone and you don't know why.
Swinging away, and now the count will be 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Hit high and deep to left field. Gone! It's a grand slam.
Stuck between a rock and a hard place. Well, that was the case here. Bases loaded, facing the
ladies and gentlemen,
The regular season is winding down, but the postseason races are heating up.